Good morning, welcome to our European morning update. And we've got some movement in the markets this morning for sure. First up, the Federal Reserve last night, of course, it raised interest rates by 75 basis points. That had been, suggested, telegraphed to some extent. Various banks had upped their forecast, the market had priced it in fully. It had not been what the Fed had been talking about. In May, at the last meeting, it said it wasn't discussing 75 basis points, but the shift in inflation, not just the CPI number, which rose to 8.6% on Friday, but also expectations, University of Michigan consumer expectations, 5-year inflation, a number rose from 3 to 3.3% at that, and that again was also reported on Friday. So the Fed has moved. Markets broadly saw the positive in this. A suggestion from Jay Powell that the next move might not be another 75, but could be 50. So market expectations for the terminal rate, the rate that's the highest that we think they'll get to in the cycle. The market shaved 20 basis points off that number on those comments. And that saw markets rally, so the S&P was up 1.5%, NASDAQ doing even better than that. And European markets a bit mixed this morning, they had rallied yesterday. So it's a mixed picture, waiting to see whether this rally from the US equity market holds. Futures not looking quite so bright this morning. Elsewhere, we've got the Bank of England coming up. That's due at 12 o'clock UK time, expecting a 25 basis point hike again. But they could go for more. There is a chance that they do 50, and that might be what sterling needs to get off the floor. It's rather fallen out of bed this morning, sinking back under 121. Not quite at the lows, the year-to-date lows, but not that far off, around 1207. Elsewhere, the Swiss National Bank has raised rates by 50 basis points, a bit of a surprise. So the Swissies bid, Euro CHF is down to 102 from 104 earlier before the meeting announcement. So it's a mixed picture from the central banks in that they're moving at different speeds, but we do know that they're moving and hiking rates, and that's what's driving the price action in the market. So that's everything to look out for today, and we'll bring you some more updates later.